Hey, Mike. How many times have you heard somebody say, "Wow, this was a lot harder than I thought it'd be"?
All the time. I think I heard you say it this morning.
I think I see it a few times a week. I mean, coding, no matter how long you've been doing it, is always difficult. Problems always come up.
That's true. In reality, the sign of a good developer isn't someone who's very smart. It's someone who's good at solving problems and can persevere. You're going to run into problems. You're going to get frustrated. There will be times you are confused. And you're going to program yourself into a corner that seems inescapable.
Whenever you run into these situations, it's important that you keep going. And I don't mean keep going in the sense that you just bang your head against the wall and get more and more frustrated. I mean going in the sense that day after day, little by little, you can just make some progress. That's how you can get through any problem. To help out, here are a few problem-solving strategies. First off, there's sleeping on it. Seriously, it's helpful. Take a break, come back fresh, and you'll be surprised to find how much easier some problems get. You also have Google and Stack Overflow to help out. Most of the time, your errors are going to have messages. Copy and paste those messages into Google, and you'll be surprised to find out how quickly you can get answers to your questions. Stack Overflow is awesome because people vote on answers, so you can get a sense of what strategy the community thinks will solve a problem. Seriously, this is a great strategy and will solve lots and lots and lots of problems for you. But hey, speaking of community, try asking the community. You aren't alone. Remember, you're going to be learning alongside a lot of other people. Reach out and ask for help. If you're lucky enough to know some web developers in real life, talk to them too. They might be able to point you in the right direction. And sometimes you might need to rethink what you're doing. When I'm working on something complicated, I like to draw a picture. This picture is an actual drawing I made the other night for an actual project. It's not very pretty, it's just pencil and graph paper, but it really doesn't have to be. Shapes, words, and arrows are often good enough. This drawing turned out to be super helpful for me and wound up saving me a lot of work later. So it's often helpful to get your ideas on paper and stop juggling them in your head. You'll be able to make better decisions if you can see the whole picture. And lastly, I want you to look at your mistakes and missteps as learning opportunities. Look at it like this. You're never really wrong, you just aren't right yet.
That's really solid advice. I think I've done all of those things throughout my career.
Yeah, I think we all have. I mean, as you well know, the best thing is at the end of the day, the feeling is just absolutely incredible when something starts to work. We want you to keep these techniques in mind as you work on your nano degree and beyond.
You'll be evolving as you learn and get better at pushing through the problems you face.
To help you remember this, I want you to write a quick little reflection on how you'll push through the challenges ahead of you.